having a partner. You'll settle for safety.
Thirteen, Alex Higgins. Griffiths Mountjoy, 17, Higgins Charlton, 49.
That's a very good safety shot indeed. Bye, Eddie. Terry can, of course, hit the red on the side cushion. But getting safe of it is very difficult indeed. And you'll have in mind that the opposing side would only need two reds and two colours to win this frame. And tie the match at seven frames all. Very important stage of this semi-final match. What would you play here, Ray?
I think I'd have as many problems as Terry's got down there. He's thinking of hitting this one on the side cushion full in the face and letting the white run into the right-hand corner, but it's a very dodgy shot. It is nearly tight on the cushion, and that does make it, if he elected to pot, a little bit easier, but very chancy. Try to come off the side cushion and hit the red very thin, take the white back to balk, but great chance for Alex Higgins here. It would appear he can't pot that one over the left-hand corner, but from our angle, it certainly looked on.
That was certainly a slice of good fortune if Higgins can't pot that red. Just a fraction of an inch would have made all the difference. He obviously can't pot it.
I think that might have been a very clever safety shot from Alex, because I think the two reds to the left of the black are nearly a possible plant for the left-hand corner, so that's why he didn't take the white down board. Doug faced with the same problem now. been a good safety shot from Doug Mountjoy, that.
To hand it to Eddie Charlton, his return to balk have been perfectly weighted throughout this match. And those a bit fortunate kissing that green to go behind the brown. It's just an example of how well he has been playing defensively.
Judging ball.
Well, Griffith's got himself out of trouble pretty well there. Just imagine that white will find itself behind the green or the brown after this shot.
Well, of course, referee John Smythe has said the white is touching the red, which means that Alex can aim away without hitting a red at all and be deemed to have played a fair shot. But not too easy to get the white safe and leave Doug Mountjoy in trouble. There you see it, a possible long pot now for Doug Mountjoy. Not easy, but certainly a definite chance. 32 points they trail in this vital 14th frame.
One.
And six. Now Doug wanting a good position shot off this red to set himself in a fine position to get the rest of the ball. Not too easy.
Seven.
Just about the perfect angle on the blue to come down for the red to the left of the black. Well, electing to 12. Take the one down the cushion. And although if it had got it, 12, he would have really set himself up, it was a little bit harder to play.
Higgins Charlton 49, Griffiths Mountjoy 29.
So the difference 20 points in favour of Eddie Charlton and Alex Higgins, and a good chance for Eddie to get a red colour and another red to put this frame safe.
One. Six.
Well, Eddie Charlton's got himself into trouble here again. He could have tied this frame up there, but an initial bad red, difficult position on the blue to get onto that final red. He's contacted the black and I don't think he's going to be able to pop this straight. He'll probably elect to go up behind the brown.
Six, nice. Eric Charlton.
He's done it his own way, and it's a superb shot again.
Higgins Charlton, 55.
Perfect snooker. Now, is this a free ball?
Well, six, Higgins, Charlton.
Well, I'm pretty sure it is a free ball from our angle.
Free ball.
Alex perfect on the pink. It'll count as a red in the first instance. This blue and
one.
That red should certainly put Alex Higgins and Eddie Charlton safe this frame. ¾ points the difference.
Six. Seven. Nine. 11. Alex Higgins. Frame conceded, Higgins and Charlton.
So, Terry Griffiths and Doug Mountjoy concede that 14th frame, levels the match, 7 frames all, and now everything to play for.
If you want to know what Annie Walker is getting for Christmas, if you want to know why Rex Harrison doesn't own a house, if you want to know how a taxi driver won $500,000 on the horses, if you want to know what Mike Yarwood says behind Stanley Baxter's back, and if you want to know what's coming on ITV and Channel 4 over the week ahead, you need TV Times.
There's so much more than TV Times in TV Times magazine. Christmas Wonderland at Woolworths. Many things to choose from, come and see. Chevron tape recordings, hear them Christmas morning. Philips blank cassettes, 1, 2, 3. GKN makes super screw for the handyman. Common heat when curled so easily. Woolworth prices, is it any wonder at Christmas? Woolworth
to be. A Merry Christmas.
She's a lovely companion. I never realised what it was like to have a cat. She prefers whiskers to anything. When I open a tin of whiskers for Sammy Cat, the first thing I see is the fact that the tin is really full. It's real good, meaty value. It's all what it says it is. Worth the money all the time. Whiskers has to be economical because there is never a speck left on the plate. I wouldn't change from Whiskers. I'm totally convinced that it's the best cat food anyone can buy.
Whiskers Supermeat, in tests, 8 out of 10 owners who expressed a preference said their cats preferred it.
Yamaha, Yamaha, yum yum, Yamaha, 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 yum yum, Yamaha, 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 yum yum, Yamaha, Yamaha.
So this is Christmas.
This is the John Lennon Collection.
What have you done? Love is asking.
His finest solo work on one outstanding album.
To be loved.
Duracell is no ordinary battery. Proof? We powered one fisherman's torch with Duracell, the rest with ordinary zinc carbon batteries. After a few hours, the ordinary batteries die. But Duracell keeps going strong, in this continuous test lasting six times longer. If it runs on batteries, it'll run much longer on Duracell, with a copper-colored top. No ordinary battery looks like it, or lasts like it.
And welcome back. So from a point last night when Alex Higgins and Eddie Charlton were four down, they've won successive frames to level the match with Terry Griffiths and Doug Mountjoy. It's seven all, the best of 19 frames, each needing three to win. Let's join frame 15, Griffiths and Mountjoy leading by 40 points to 30. Doug Mountjoy is at the table and he's on a break of 24.
Well, Doug Mountjoy's underhit that black. It's questionable whether he can pop this blue into this red into the middle pocket. If he can't, he may tackle a fine cut into the left-hand pocket. See professionals looking at them from both sides, that's from the angle that they're hitting it from, and the one that the pocket the ball's going into, it certainly is very fine. Thought twice about it, but dropped in the end. Stood on the wrong side of that blue.
Doug Mountjoy. Higgins Charlton 30, Griffiths Mountjoy 54.
Well, I thought for a moment there that Eddie Charlton had slipped up and left Terry Griffiths a potting chance, but rubber the green literally puts him behind the green.
Terry's thinking about the alternative here of knocking that red that's in the balk area in off the other red and playing safe at the same time. That's one of the options at least. The red, but he moved the red that was hanging over that right-hand pocket.
And I think that's about the first red Terry's potted for something over two frames.
Eight.
32 points in front now.
Nine.
So 40 points 16. The difference, this red and the colour. Anything above the green will leave Higgins and Charlton requiring snookers.
17. Twenty-two, Terry Griffiths.
Yes, Alex Higgins and Eddie Charlton leading snookers. They couldn't get them, and the Welsh were back in front again. And what a marvellous match they are producing for us. You can see the climax in our highlights programme tonight and also the finish of the other semi-final between Steve Davis and Tony Meo and Tony Knowles and Jimmy White. Join me later tonight on ITV.
That was pretty unfortunate for Eddie Charlton there.
And Eddie Charlton now coming over to have a look, so it must be pretty tight. Well, I'm not sure what Eddie said there. Possibly he may have disagreed with the referee. The referee is the man in charge. If he makes the decision, the players have got to abide by it. And he's a pretty competent referee, is John Smythe.
Terry Griffiths playing the brown here, which of course will count as a red. After this he'll be on a colour. It hasn't gone quite as far through as he wanted. I think he might have got just a little bit of a kick from that shot.
One.
Been a little bit unfortunate there. That could easily have split up nicely for him, as it is.
Six.
There isn't an easy red on, I don't think. Possibility that this red will go into the middle.
7.
But still struggling a little bit for position. Pink nice and handy over the pocket, but not easy to keep the cue ball onto the reds.
Well, Terry's certainly working hard for these few points. May have to settle for the safety shot here. To make it as difficult as possible for the next player coming in. And that next player being Alex Higgins.
13, Terry Griffiths.
Doesn't want to give him half a chance if he can help it. I do believe Alex is looking at putting one red in off the other red. That would be pretty spectacular if it comes off. Well, that's in fact what he tried. Missed the other red, but he looks very happy with that. I think I've seen a little smile from Alex. Yeah, he's managed to leave everything pretty safe. Just having a little sip of his Coke.
Higgins Charlton 31, Griffiths Mountjoy 45.
Oh, Eddie Charlton coming to the table, 14 points behind, but chance to knock the red into the corner pocket here.
Not happy with things at the moment. He could just hit the cushion in front of the red. That would help him to get the white out into position for pink or black. It'll be very interesting to see how he plays this shot. In fact, he did hit the cushion first, but didn't negotiate the pot, so a chance gone there.
That worked out quite well for Alex. He didn't intend to hit the cushion first, but played a thin snick onto that red to send the cue ball down the ball can, but it's all worked out very well. Completely safe. And a very tense moment in this 16th frame. Very important frame, of course. The scores could be all level after this, or Terry Griffiths and Doug Mountjoy could be two frames in front. First side to get to 10, of course, wins the semi-final.
Well, that's a mistake from Eddie here. Chance now for Terry Griffiths.
One.
Well, with the two reds on the top cushion, still a lot of work to do. Hasn't really got an angle here on the pink to cannon into the red. The black is stopping the path. That green certainly not helping the situation either. Well, that's about as good as he possibly could have done. Has left a possible red along the top cushion.
Seven.
What an important ball this is, Dennis. If he pops this one in, he should be nicely on the black. He misses it, of course, he could leave the game on. No, and that wriggled in nicely.
Eight.
Twenty-two points in front now. This black will make it 29. Just this red 15. To make the frame comparatively safe.
Sixteen. 30
points in front now. This black makes it 37 with just 27 points left on the table. So Alex Higgins and Eddie Charlton requiring at the moment three smokes.
23.
Pretty daunting task.
25. 28. Thirty-two. 37. Terry Griffiths.
Well, Alex Higgins decided to come to the table. One wonders why. This shows one of his spectacular shots. Obviously no chance of winning the frame.
Six.
And how about that for a positional shot?
13. Alex Higgins frames Griffiths and Mountjoy.
So Terry Griffiths and Doug Mountjoy go into a two-frame lead. 9-7, needing just one more to clinch this match.
So Griffiths and Mountjoy building up a lead again and now needing only one frame to clinch that place in the final. Join us for the outcome in just a moment.
Hi there. It's record blitz time at Woolworths, with tapes the same low prices as records. It's the Fab Four. And Elkie Brooks. Write me a song. A Barry Manilow cassette. Fab-a-rooney. A musical youth. Wonderful. Madness. 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 It's Phil Collins. I must be going. Bye. Tear along to Woolworths for a record Christmas.
Christmas and a half.
Diamond rings and pearls might suit other girls. I think they may be sham. Gold may always glimmer, stars above may shimmer, but nothing sparkles like a baby sham.
And welcome back. Well, we left that semi-final with Terry Griffiths and Doug Mountjoy having established a two-frame lead over Eddie Charlton and Alex Higgins. It's 9-7. Let's move on to frame 17 now. The Welshmen lead again, but this time by 43 points to 30, and it's Terry Griffiths at the table.
Now is the pressure starting to creep in. And that cue ball's coming towards the top pocket. Well, Alex was almost stamping the floor there. And just have a look where that's finished.
Yes, Terry was certainly a little bit fortunate there. Had the white dropped in, of course, the red was on into the ball pocket.
He's made a little bit of a mess of that shot.
Griffiths Mountjoy, 43. Higgins Charlton, 30.
The one consolation. After Doug Mountjoy pots this red, the other two reds are not in a very favourable position.
One.
He has the one red on the top cushion. To get onto that one would require a very deep screw shot here.
One took Mountjoy.
Well, once again, a bit fortunate to get away with that. That looks completely safe.
Touching ball.
In fact, John Smart decides that it's touching the red, so Eddie Charlton must play away from that red now without disturbing it. Be deemed to have hit it. And he's just having a look to see just exactly where he wants to place the cue ball to make it as difficult as possible for the incoming player. And just play the cue ball onto the side cushion and take it down behind the yellow, close as possible to that ball cushion, I would think.
Playing for a lot of money here. The two players that lose are guaranteed 6,000. The winners go on with a possible chance of winning £24,000. Once again, that could have been a lot worse. The run of the ball certainly with the two Welsh players at the moment. But as I said earlier, that's what you need to win major tournaments. Where's the cue ball going? Well, would you believe it?
Four, Griffiths Mountjoy.
Alex pulled one out of the fire there. Cannoned into the blue and went into the corner pocket, so... Well, there's not a lot they can do about that.
Griffiths Mountjoy, 48. Higgins Charlton, 30.
But still a lot of snooker left in this match. Just 18 points behind. That's an excellent safety shot from Doug Mountjoy. Doesn't really want to disturb these two reds very much. He could come off the side cushion just above the right center pocket and nestle onto the reds. And Alex, well, he doesn't seem to want to know about this shot. Crucial shot coming up.
To Mountjoy.
I don't think Alex will be too disappointed. He didn't make contact with the reds, but certainly hasn't left one, John.
Two.
That's amazing, the reach. Alex Higgins has the cue ball almost up in the pink spot, and he's made of rubber, this man, I think. A little unlucky. He wanted to try and get the cue ball in behind the brown.
The last two shots from Doug Mountjoy have been absolutely perfect shots. Once again, he's played and got Eddie Charlton into real trouble again.
Too happy with that. Couldn't really do a lot with that, just had to play to get out of the snooker. Unfortunately, he's left it over the left corner pocket.
And one feels, Dennis, that with a lead of 22 at the moment, Terry Griffiths could finish off this match here. Pot of colour and get onto that last red would mean that Higgins and Charlton would require snookers.
And what an enjoyable match this has been, John. Some excellent snooker. We've had terrific potting, terrific safety play.
Seven.
This match has certainly had everything.
Yes, when you think, Dennis, that at one time last night the Welsh team were leading by 7-3 and looked to be coasting to a reasonably good victory, and then lost 4 of the next 5 frames. And we really had a match on our hands. As if Terry wasn't bothered about leaving himself snookered on the yellow, as long as he could knock that black in. Puts him into a pretty impregnable position now. 37 points in front.
15.
With just 27 points on the table. Oh, well,
15, Terry
Griffiths. Requiring 3 snookers and the last 6 balls if they're to stay alive in this match.
I'm sure Doug Mountjoy is feeling very happy at this moment. Not a snooker for Eddie Charlton. can just see the edge of the yellow.
Well, that worked out well. Not only potted the yellow, but kissed the green nicely over the pocket.
Five. Nine.
And what a difference when one can relax, knowing that the frame is all over, that brown went in without any trouble at all.
Nine, Terry Griffiths.
Forty-six points in the frame now, with just a mere 18 points left on the table. And it's anybody's guess what Alex tried to do there.
Attempting a snooker there, but I feel sure they've given up any hope.
Five.
Terry Griffiths and Doug Mountjoy win the match by 10 frames to 7 and go through to the final.
Congratulations, Terry and Doug. That was a marvellous semi-final, but a very hard one, obviously.
It's always hard. Sometimes it's harder than others, but it's never easy. And nobody likes semi-finals, and it's hard for somebody to lose semi-final always, but we struggled through in the end. Thanks to Doug earlier on.
I'm just wondering what was passing through your mind when you saw them come back to 7-all, Doug?
I was frightened to death. But, as Terry has said, it's been an hard semi-final, and of course everyone wants to get to the final. And I found the pressure on me, especially the last few frames there. And of course, missed a few balls, but thankfully I got a partner, so.
Where did you feel the pressure most, do you think, Terry?
I feel the pressure all the time. That's why I play so quick.
Oh, yes, I've heard about
it. I shake all the time. I find the pressure very hard, but it's very enjoyable as well. But earlier on in the match this afternoon, Doug played very well, and I just couldn't do anything. And Alex and Eddie were just stopping us play. Well, stopping me playing, certainly. And Doug potted well. I just couldn't do anything, but he just could hopefully, you know, carry on. And with the team together, we get through in the end. But I must mention in the last game when they had that... That in off here was very hard lines, I think, for Alex, because he played a good shot and went to kiss the blue out, and it's a vital part of the game, and he went in off in the bottom pocket, and that can, of course, be the difference between winning and losing in the end, really.
Well, you're through. It's going to be the best of 25 frames. You're playing either Steve Davis and Tony Meo or Jimmy White and Tony Knowles. We'll know that tonight. Have you any preference for your opponents, Doug?
I'm just pleased he'd been in the final, Dickie, yeah.
Well, having pulled level, Alex, to 7-all, it was a hard one to lose, wasn't it, eventually?
Yeah, it got at me slightly. You know, I felt a little bit... I'm lost for words. I just felt very, very bad.
You really were optimistic last night, Eddie. We had the discussion and you suggested if we could pull level, we really could win this one. You did that, but you couldn't sustain it throughout the end.
No, well, it was one of those things. I don't think it was meant to be. I mean, Alex played well right through the tournament. For the first time in the whole match, we got a little bit of running in that first session, but after the interval, very little went right, and that's just can make the difference. I mean, Terry's left the wide ball right on the fall of the pocket on three occasions, and it damn thing wouldn't drop. And the shot that Alex played there to bring the blue out was an excellent shot, but of course he's gone in off, so... Dickie, I've enjoyed the tournament. It's been great playing with Alex, and it's been a wonderful tournament, a great idea, and I think the sponsors and promoters are to be congratulated because they've done a marvellous job, and it's been a real thrill to play in it, and I hope it's on again next year.
Would you want to play with Alex next year at all?
Yes, he'd only have to ask me, and I'd only be too pleased. But I can understand if he wants to get a younger partner, OK?
Come on, let's have a few words about your partner, Alex.
Now, Eddie, I mean... The actual name, Steady Eddie, I thought, well, the guy's going to do the business and put them in trouble. But it's a completely different game when you were out of the game so much and what have you. And, okay, I enjoyed the tournament. I'd love to have won it and whatever. But, I mean, when you don't get that many shots, it's hard to get into some sort of rhythm. And against what all the press say, we're good friends, you know, and... maybe next year, if he comes to my house and pays for all the lessons, we can be partners again next year.
Well, Alex Higgins smiling, but inwardly feeling that great disappointment of defeat. So, Terry Griffiths and Doug Mountjoy through to the final. But who will their opponents be? Join us again in just a moment.